began to tell at the beginning. The story that got disrupted and forgotten about as it yielded to the greater urgency of describing, that is recognizing, that is celebrating Adrienne's life, the story of a name that haunted me, can now be returned to. It was a diaspora song of mourning and homecoming, a setting of a poem by Yehuda Halevi. I remembered only the refrain, between my childhood and my approaching seventh decade, I had lost the words of the verses and felt the phantom pain of generations of Jews leaving our place of sacred origins. And just here, betwixt and between worlds, Adrienne was indispensable to me, as she was for so many others. I called her with my fragment of song, and she sang for me what I needed to hear. Yamni, translated from the Hebrew of Yehuda Halevi, by Nachman Yalda. I am not a singer, but I want to directly transmit to you the world of the spirit that ceased being immaterial and lost when I was in Adrienne's company, and we traveled a while together in story or song. Hauntedness was transformed into vital presence. I can convey this only by singing to you a piece of the tradition that Adrienne restored to wholeness for me. First, a translation of the hybrid text in which the Hebrew of the medieval mystical poet enters and lives on in the Yiddish of the modern secular poet in an act of reworking and continuing our cultural and spiritual Yerusha, our inheritance, that was at the heart of Adrienne's contribution. Seesaw by Yehuda Halevi. I've forgotten all those I most love. I've left my own house. I've given myself over to the sea, carrying the sea to my mother's bosom. And you, faithful west wind, drive my ship to the other shore, to which my heart, with eagle's wings, has for so long sought away. Bring me there in peace. After that, I'll fly back to you, greet all those I most love, and tell them of my good fortune. A word on context. In every song that Adrienne sang, her knowledge of its location in the past was reflected by gesture, and the multitude of voices that she contained populated and moved through the song. The song moved from its site of origin to its current address, here and now among us. Each song derived its resonance by its double context, linking us to the unexpected ancestors Adrienne summoned into the room. In the silence following each song, it began its latest second life, a part of tradition and a part of us. In the latest double context from which Yamni receives a fresh infusion of eternal life, it mediates between the last day of Adrienne's life and this commemoration of her life. She lay inert in the ICU between her family and friends gathered in the waiting room and Jena Veldt, the other world. One or two at a time, we came to be with her. My whole relationship with Adrienne prepared me for being with her then, as it does now. I began singing to her, and in this I was joined by the friend who was already in the room, kissing and caressing her. Together we sang a ninny that neither of us had ever heard until it spontaneously came out of us. Later, when I was alone with her, I sang her Lomirala Zingin Azemelo, the Altered Zingin, and Yamud. As I was singing Yamud, her right eye was closed, and her left eye half opened. And with her left hand and my right resting in each other, she lightly squeezed my fingers once. It was enough to let me know she was with me, receiving into her soul Was mein Herz mit